Hello, I'm Jill Tiefenthaler, CEO of the National Geographic Society. I'm thrilled to be at Base Camp, our headquarters in Washington, D.C., for this very exciting day to celebrate you, the participants of our Slingshot Challenge. We've been eagerly awaiting this moment since we launched the challenge last fall as a new opportunity to empower young people who have innovative ideas about protecting our planet. Reaching this point was the culmination of many individuals coming together, including dozens of society staff who, along with our dedicated team of explorer mentors and judges, helped bring this initiative to life. I also want to thank our partner, the Paul G. Allen Family Foundation, which envisions a world where youth are empowered to thrive. And of course, we thank you, the participants, teams, and classrooms who submitted your bright ideas. But before we announce our winners, let's take a minute to remember where the Slingshot Challenge began. In October 2022, we set out with one goal in mind, to slingshot our planet forward with innovative new ideas around conservation solutions. The Slingshot Challenge was designed to empower young people 13 to 18 years old who have creative ideas about protecting our planet in five key ways: by cleaning the air, restoring the ocean, protecting nature, reducing waste, and addressing climate change. And you answered the call. We were astounded by the response. We received 15,000 signups and 1,800 submissions from across 80 countries. That was thanks in no small part to you sharing this challenge with your networks. You helped generate nearly 3.5 million social media engagements. And your creative approaches to solving our environment's urgent and challenging problems impressed our panel of judges. We knew it would be hard to select the winners, but we're truly overwhelmed by the creativity and imagination you all showed us in your submissions. As you crafted your ideas and created your videos, we were pleased to connect you with young explorers like Marcus Martinez Berman and Andy Vijaral Rodriguez for guidance. And I'm excited to share that Andy's here with me now. Andy, can you give us a recap of some of our young explorers' work with Slingshot?
Sure, thanks Jill. It's so exciting to be here at Base Camp to honor all the participants of this year's Slingshot Challenge and to announce the winners. For the past 5 months, we've talked through your ideas, brainstormed solutions, and created amazing content together. We also worked with other explorers, like Marcus, to host workshops and design labs to support you throughout the challenge. All of that hard work has led us to today's celebration. Let's take a look at some of the impactful ideas that our finalists have created. But before we reveal our winners, we asked all of you to vote on your favorite submission on the Videos for Change platform. We would like to give a special congratulations to the winner of the popular vote.
Cleaning the air through a community-driven cycle club, resolving the plight of smog.
As we get closer to announcing our winners, let's take a look at the 15 finalists. These videos were submitted from the United States, Turkey, Mexico, Canada, Nigeria, Pakistan, and South Africa. These 15 submissions rose to the top as part of the multi-stage judging process over nearly 2 months that involved an administrative review and scoring using our Slingshot rubric. This group of 15 stood out because of their alignment to the Slingshot selection criteria, including effective communication, uniqueness and feasibility of their solution idea, emotional impact, video making techniques, and connection to community. These finalists embody the passion that all the Slingshot changemakers have for confronting our planet's biggest issues. And we are delighted to know that you are the future of conservation. Congratulations to the finalists.
And the winners are using the power of social media to connect local waste reducers. No Waste Nation.
This is consumerism.
It's our culture.
We buy more than we need year after year, producing more and more waste.
Consumerism makes us wasteful.
I was shocked to learn that 99% of items we purchase are discarded within 6 months.
Many of those items use plastic, which takes up to 500 years to decompose.
And energy from manufacturing, transporting, and using these products encourages excess use of fossil fuels, the source of our climate crisis.
Here's my idea.
Like Nat Geo explorers, Ruthie Gurudev created an e-magazine to unite ocean conservationists, let's use social media to unite waste producers. I started No Waste Nation, a platform where I highlight unique waste producers in my community to inspire others to reduce waste themselves.
Let's grow this movement. Let's use the power of media to make reducing waste cool.
We can work together to shift away from the culture of consumerism. Join us at No Waste Nation. I started to make my video for the Slingshot Challenge by conducting a community survey about reducing waste. I found that while many of my peers undertook daily actions like using a reusable water bottle or cutting down on plastic packaging, many did not feel comfortable encouraging others to reduce waste. I really like the idea of using social media to unite youth towards a greater environmental cause. So that, combined with my research in consumerism, is how No Waste Nation and my submission for the Slingshot Challenge were born. My generation is expected to fix the climate crisis, and that's a lot of pressure. So I hope by helping to slingshot this planet forward, future generations won't have to carry this burden of saving the planet.
Cleaning the air through a community-driven cycle club. Resolving the plight of smog.
We turned this to this. Seeing the poor air quality of Lahore, we, a group of optimistic teenagers, arose from amongst Behria Town and analyzed this problem. Seeing the active participation of students of our school to answer our questionnaires in favor of cycling helped us choose the right path, and hence we came to a reasonable solution, launching a cycling club in our school named Two Wheel Thrill. We created a cycle zone in our school premises and are working on encouraging students to prefer cycles over cars. Firstly, only 1 to 2 students come to school on bicycles, but we aim to make this at least 25 to 30. Furthermore, we also wrote emails to the Behria Town management to construct proper cycling lanes in the Behria community, which will not only help the students of Beacon House, but the entire Behria community. This will reduce smog problems in Behria Town, and as we are spreading this idea, so different towns in Lahore will hopefully take inspiration from us and take a step towards a more sustainable Lahore.
Protecting nature through photography and storytelling. Save the forests.
I want to help save this forest. The challenge is getting other people to care. But how can someone grow to care about something if they don't see it or even know it's there? There's a small stretch of forest here in Massachusetts that a company wants to clear. If it's approved by my town, crucial Massachusetts wildlife habitat will be turned into a parking lot. As Nat Geo explorer Joel Sartori says, it's all about telling the story of wild animals in a way that gets people to stop and pay attention. I've been using motion-activated cameras to tackle this. I'm revealing the unseen wildlife that calls these patches of woods their home. Allowing the woods to be destroyed sets the precedent that it's okay to keep removing the few forests we have left. We're collaborating with local communities' outreach efforts to help conserve these wildlife habitats. I hope my town's decision makers are moved by my photos and the creatures whose lives they are affecting. Save the forest! So I remember I set up my camera in the woods. I waited a week and I was so excited. I had so much anticipation to see what I got. And I finally, after an impatient 7 days, went out, took my memory card out, put on my laptop, photos loaded up, and I saw the most beautiful photo of a eastern coyote. I just felt like an instant connection with this animal. When I showed it to my community, the response was the same, and it was just cool to see how one photo could make such a large impact. I really want to spread the message of deforestation in my film. I think it's important for people to see that they are able to make an impact, just like I was able to.
Protecting nature through community education to prevent poaching and logging. Our environment, our responsibility.
Our school is located in Nubusa, a town endowed with wealth of nature like the River Niger and its lake, the Kanji Lake, whose fish population has greatly reduced due to bad fishing techniques by the locals. Wildlife in Nubusa forest areas have led to the establishment of the national park, but the population of these animals is greatly reducing due to poaching. The town is naturally a Guinea savanna area, but it is now losing its natural existence due to deforestation and lumbering activities. We believe each child is a unit of a family, and each family a unit of the community. When a child is well informed, he goes on to affect and effect change in his or her environment. We have an existing enlightenment program, but empowered with $10,000, we would enlarge our enlightenment programs from not only within our school, but to other schools and to the locals as well. We would also direct our funds towards afforestation programs in the national park and teaching the local fishermen on fish farming to reduce production pressure on the lake. We would also sponsor a lake cleanup program to remove non-biodegradable items from the lake.
Welcome to the Slingshot Challenge.
It is important to make positive impacts on the planet because the planet is our only home and we have to prolong the lifespan of the planet.
The video started by us as a team coming together brainstorming on different ideas. We were inspired by our teacher who taught us on environmental conservation.
My favorite memory from preparing and competing in the Slingshot Challenge thus far was when I watched the finished 1 minute video and received a fresh dose of fire and passion to help my environment.
I see myself inspiring other people to be aware of their responsibility to their environment.
Addressing climate change by rehabilitating ecosystems affected by forest fires. Farista Vivero.
Somos estudiantes de San Luis Potosí, México. A partir de los incendios forestales de 2019 que afectaron el área natural protegida de la Sierra de San Miguelito,
decidimos contribuir para restaurar el ecosistema dañado. Realizamos excursiones para recolectar semillas nativas, con las cuales generamos plantas que más adelante sembraremos en las áreas afectadas.
Y para facilitar su crecimiento, restauramos el suelo elaborando bombas de semillas de pastos, flores y arbustos nativos, las cuales lanzamos en la misma sierra.
Hicimos un jardín de polinizadores y difundimos información sobre nuestro trabajo para generar conciencia sobre la importancia del cuidado del ecosistema.
Con esto ayudamos a disminuir el CO2, combatir la desertificación y degradación del suelo y recuperar el hábitat de la vida silvestre.
Pensamos que este proyecto es una opción efectiva y fácil de replicar para que los jóvenes del mundo contribuyan a mejorar el planeta.
Mi momento favorito al realizar el Slingshot Challenge fue cuando tuvimos que idear un guión donde compilara todo nuestro trabajo y mi grupo y yo nos dimos cuenta de cuánto trabajo habíamos llevado a cabo, la evolución del proyecto y cómo es tan grande el impacto que tiene en el medio ambiente. Buscamos ganar este concurso para difundir el proyecto, que se pueda multiplicar y replicar en varias partes del mundo para que distintos jóvenes o adultos o niños puedan apoyar y dar su granito de arena para el apoyo del medio ambiente, para su cuidado y su preservación.
Wow, what an incredible year for the Slingshot Challenge. As an educator and a parent, it's always been incredibly important to me to guide talented young people during some of the most transformative periods of their lives. It's one of the reasons why I was so excited to be a part of the National Geographic Society, because of its commitment to celebrating and amplifying the voices of up-and-coming change makers. Thank you again to all of our participants and congratulations to all of our winners. We can't wait to welcome you here to our base camp for our annual Explorers Festival in Washington, D.C. this summer. This event will be the perfect opportunity to connect with one another and celebrate the amazing work all those in our Nat Geo community are doing to illuminate and protect the wonder of our world. Lastly, mark your calendars. I encourage you all to participate again next year. Develop new ideas and dream up innovative solutions. Visit slingshotchallenge.org to learn more about year 2 and stay up to date with all of our announcements. Thank you.